In this video presentation, we're going to have a look at the Instinct range by Crabtree. We've looked at this rig before, we've done it for the two plate method, and I've gone on and extended it over a series of videos, including showing you the connections at the switches, these both being two-way switches. And it's actually the layout of the connections on the back of the Instinct range accessories that is a little bit different. So we take a standard one gang, two-way switch. The usual arrangement is a common terminal, L1 and L2 laid out like so. The Instinct range has all their terminations in a row. So if we take a socket outlet and have a look at the back of that, we've got all our termination positions rowed out. So we go, this one here, we go neutral, CPC, CPC, and line. If we look at a fused connection unit, we've got them all in a row as well. So we've got a set of three here and a set of three there. So let's have a look at what they've done with the two-way switch. So one gang, two-way switch, and again, we've got them in a line, common, L1 and L2. There's some other features that I want to show you about these that make it a strong product to select being an electrical contractor, but also really good points for my students. After using the traditional screw-down terminations, slightly different the approach they've gone with their actual connections on the Instinct range. So we'll just bring the camera in, I'm going to terminate one of these, and we're going to talk about the actual connections that have been made in the back of this accessory. So let's try and have a look at the back of one of these Instinct one gang two-way switches. So one gang, so I turn it over. Oh, a little bit interesting there. I can see a bit of a GSH Electrical logo. What they've done is they've used laser etching in order to etch on my logo onto the front of the switch. You could have had it identified what the switch was doing, maybe a QR code or something like that. So really nice touch that you can actually have. It's not a transfer, it's etched into the actual plastic itself. If I move it across here, they did me actually two. So I've got one there with GSH Electrical on. So this is on the Instinct range. So let's have a look at what's clever about the back of these. As well as them being in a line, there's some really good features, especially for colleges, I think. They've got captive screws. So in other words, doesn't matter how much I unwind that screw, it won't come out. It's held into place. How many times have you been in an electrical workshop where you pull out a switch and find that you have one of the screws missing? So if you've got a common L1 and L2 and one of them's missing, the switch is almost redundant unless you find one to replace it with, you end up putting them in the bin. These have got captive screws. In other words, they cannot come out. The other really, really nice feature is their cage terminals. So no longer have we got the screw head going in and penetrating into the copper conductor. It's actually closing the cage up. So I'll try and do that for you. So we see that cage hopefully just closing down in order to clamp. So that will make a better connection, especially as you're learning your trade, to make sure we grasp the conductors within that cage. And again, as we back it off, you can't actually lose the screw either. So let's put a conductor in and have a look at that. So if I take a 1 mm² cable, I put it into my common connection, I tighten that up, it will close the cage down. Get it nice and tight and grasp that connection. So there you go. So we can't lose the screw. Brilliant for colleges, brilliant for the electrical industry and rolling around looking for one in the box. But think about it from a college point of view. Can't lose the screw, and now we've got the ability to close the cage in here in order to grasp the actual conductor itself and not a single screw that could penetrate and break a conductor. I really, really like that. Laying them out at the top, that's different. Okay, I like things that are different. But the captive screw and cage terminal set this apart for me. And of course, when you get your own logo on the front, obviously that's a really sweet moment as well. Let's have a look at the back of a socket outlet. So exactly the same technology gone on here. We've got them all in a row. We've got neutral, two CPC connections, which is fantastic, and a line connection. And again, they're captive screws, so can't back them up any more than that. They will not come out. And there are again cage terminals. So again, I close the cage down like so in order to clasp my actual conductors themselves, back it back off, all the way backed up, can't back it off anymore. Screw won't be lost, college will be happy. We've got the, these have got neons or LEDs effectively in here. So we've got LEDs in here for identification for these type, they're orange. And again, as always, you've got the ability to pull out the tab at the back when testing. So you remove that LED light. Otherwise, when you pass your 500 volts through for insulation resistance, you'll get a false reading. You'll also get them to glow. So that's those. And our switched fused connection unit. Turn it over again. We've got the supply section and the load section in a row at the top. CPC line and neutral, neutral line and CPC. And again, you can pull it out in order to remove the LED, which is built in here within the switch when doing your testing. So I really like that nice little touch. So a massive thanks to Crabtree, okay, for putting my logo on the front of a couple of switches. I think these switches are going to appear in my children's bedrooms. I think there'll be nothing better than seeing Dad's logo every time you turn your light on and off to go to bed. And what I like from a college aspect here on this Instinct range is the fact that we've got captive screws, can't lose them, and the cage terminals mean that the students will get the best possible electrical connection as they're learning their trade. I like the fact they're in a row. I think that's a little bit different, especially on the socket outlets and the fuse connection units. I really like that touch. But from a college point of view, captive screws and cage terminations are a real winner. And again, massive thanks to the guys and girls at Crabtree for putting my logo on one of their switches. So for now, I hope this video has been some help.